Good evening, good morning to everyone. The title of my paper is The Worldly Conceived of Violin, as the old Czech is inherently connected with Czechian to the Vulgate text. However, I will mainly focus on the parabiblical texts that have often accompanied Latin translations of the particular books of the Bible, because in the last 2 years, me and my colleagues from the Department of Czech Language Development have dealt with these texts within the grant project Old Czech Biblical Prologues, whose main output was a critical edition with an introductory study. It was published in June this year, and if anyone's interested, I have one copy here. So, prologues have accompanied the text in manuscripts of the Latin Vulgate since the early Middle Ages. A considerable number of prologues are associated with Saint Jerome, as they originally come from his other texts, frequently from his introductions to Latin translations of biblical books, or from his Bible commentaries, as well as from letters to his friends. In them, Jerome often summarizes the contents of the particular books, defends his translation into Latin, and explains which books actually form the biblical canon. There are also some older texts of unknown authors that usually circulated under Jerome's name as well, and many younger prefaces which appeared during the early and high Middle Ages. The first inventory of prologues in medieval Latin Bibles was published by Donatio de Bruyne in 1920, and Stegnauer's list from 1981 included 558 items. But in general, the prologues didn't take part of the biblical canon, and so their presence and in Latin Bibles varied, just like the number and content. The number and content of the prologues weren't stabilized until the appearance of the so-called Paris Bible. This textual type of the Latin Bible, produced in Paris around 1230, contains 64 prefaces to the biblical books, including 6 new prologues which cannot be found in the Bibles before the 13th century. Thanks to productive Parisian scriptoria and active booksellers, the Paris Bible became widely popular among the newly founded mendicant orders and quickly spread all over Christian Europe, thus also to Bohemia, where it became the model for the earliest translation of the Bible into Old Czech. Traces of the vernacular biblical translations in the Czech lands can already be found in the 12th century in glossed Latin texts, but these glosses are unsystematic and rather occasional. One of the oldest Czech translations, glosses can actually be found in Jerome's prologue to Jeremiah in the Latin Old Testament from almost from the 12th century. As a whole, the Bible translation was fixed in writing at the end of the 13th century, namely through the interlinear translation of the Psalter and through the Gospel Lectionary that were written for a female convent to facilitate the comprehension of the biblical text used in the liturgy. The earliest Czech translation of the entire Bible was made in the 1350s. Before 1500, there can be found 3 other versions of the translation, the so-called reductions, surviving in more than 100 manuscripts and in almost 100 fragments. If someone is more interested in the issue of Old Czech biblical reductions, we recently launched a database of late medieval biblical texts, diabible.com, that provides full text of medieval translations of the Bible into Czech from selected manuscripts and printed sources from the 14th and 15th centuries and enable their study through comparison of the particular biblical verses. However, there's just a text of the Matthew's Gospel so far, but we are working on other books. Concerning the usability of biblical translation in practice, in the second half of the 14th century, the Old Czech text was limited mainly to the monastic communities. However, with the beginning of the new century, the situation has changed. The higher nobility became interested in owning the text of the Bible in the vernacular language and ordered expensive illuminated manuscripts. These demands, together with the Hussite efforts for the laicization of the biblical world, were probably the reason for the language revisions and new translations, as well as for the increase of manuscript and print production in the 15th century. Regarding the prologues, in particular old Czech biblical productions, the earliest redaction was the collective work of two groups of translators. These differ in their use of variant terminology for certain biblical terms, and they weren't also consistent in their attitudes to the translation of the prologues in the model example of Paris Bible. The surviving manuscripts of the first reduction show that the individual translators from both groups dealt with them at their own discretion, and for some reason most of them didn't translate the prologues at all. In general, the first reduction manuscripts contain a relatively small number of prologues, only short prefaces to individual Pauline's epistles, so-called argumenta, and a peculiar version of the prologue to Matthew's Gospel. Otherwise, there are two more prologues which don't build on any familiar Latin text, but they are original works of one of the translators, so-called Dominicanus. At the time when the second and third redaction originated, at the beginning of the 15th century, some unknown author compiled an extensive collection of old Czech biblical prologues. This was probably stimulated by the revision of the earliest biblical translation when the editors attended to complement old Czech Bible according to the Latin Vulgate manuscripts, especially to the Paris Bible, mainly by adding prologues and other parabiblical texts like interpretations of Hebrew names. This separate collection contains prologues to almost all books of the entire Bible or its larger part, but offering even two or three prefaces for every biblical book, and it therefore comprises more than 100 items, in addition to the 64 prefaces from the Paris Bible. The collection contains nearly 40 other introductory texts from the earliest Latin Bibles. At least as we know, there's no similar collection of Latin prefaces, and so it seems that the old Czech compilator worked with the older non-Parisian Bibles and probably used also some Bible commentaries like Glossa Ordinaria. The Czech prologue collection has been preserved in two copies from the first quarter of the 15th century, and from these two collections, the prologues were then selectively adopted and copied before individual biblical books in 45 manuscripts and one printed book of the second and third reduction, biblical reductions. The number of the prologues in extant manuscript varies, but none of them contains the same number of prologues as the prologue collection did. And although within particular reductions, the actual text of the Bible in the 15th century underwent a number of modifications, in general, the number and selection of the prologues differ more in the Bibles of the second reduction, while the third reduction manuscripts are relatively stable in the selection of the prologues, often copying a model of the the Paris Bible. In terms of the translation itself, the author of the prologue collection had to face a demanding task, as his rendering should have achieved two aspects, the factual accuracy and comprehensibility. In the prologue, the situation is complicated by their very specific language and style. They are mostly scholarly texts with literary, historical and philological explanations, containing plenty of terms for which Czech didn't have any or established equivalents at the turn of the 14th and 15th centuries. He therefore coped with it by following the Latin text strictly and translating the prologues word for word. Sometimes he didn't understand Latin properly, and he therefore transferred the text wrong way and incomprehensibly to the reader. In several Bibles of the 15th century, some prologues have been preserved in a completely different translation by an unknown author. These independent versions contain many paraphrases and a number of interpretative explanations that aren't part of the biblical exegesis and that refer to the semantic or translational level. This style is remarkably similar to the style of the first biblical redaction, so it is questionable if this better understandable translation version is older than the prologue collection, or if it is younger and kind of a reaction to its poor quality. And besides a brand new translation of prologues appeared together with the printed Bibles in the 1480s. The first completely printed Bible, so-called Prague Bible from 1488, contains only five prologues. Four of them appear here in a new translation. The book of prologues had already had a long textual tradition. The authors of the fourth biblical redaction decided not to use any of the existing translations of biblical prologues. Instead of using the literal word-for-word translation, the translators sought to capture the meaning. Therefore, the prologues of the fourth biblical redaction don't include neologisms, archaic and obsolete words, or unusual Latin and Greek expressions, but only generally established and used terms. The fifth preface is a new text on the translation of the Psalter that was printed separately a year earlier in 1487. The introduction addresses similar topics to Jerome's prologues, but it is independent of any particular Latin origin. It deals with the difficulty of translation of this metaphorical poetic text, and it outlines the problem of translation by word in comparison with translation by sense, which aims to preserve the aesthetic value and factual accuracy. The prologue also attempts to defend the approach to the new translation of the Psalter into Old Czech, which tries to specify some unclear places based on the Latin version Psalterium used by Hebraeus. These five prologues can also be found in the printed Catholic Bibles of the 16th century, but since the 17th century they don't appear anymore. So I'm getting to a brief summary. The prefaces are the most common parabiblical texts. We can find them in most of the surviving Bibles, both manuscripts and early prints, if we count complete Bibles, New and Old Testaments. They are both translated Latin and original Czech texts. As I mentioned, that there's a collection of prologues of around 100 prologues. However, in the Old Czech biblical manuscripts of the 14th and 15th century, we overall found 124 texts. The aim of the prologues, mostly placed before individual biblical books, was to facilitate the understanding and difficult of the difficult biblical text for the readers, familiarize them with the issues of the book concerned, and outline its content. This is also the reason why they can be found in so many biblical sources. Although they are far from clear in all of them, and the number also fluctuates. Since the text of all Czech prologues were copied into numerous manuscripts, their wording was changed, with the revisions including small to essential changes. The copyist adjusted the text to the contemporary language usage on all language levels. These revisions, motivated by the effort to clarify the entire text as much as possible, sometimes resulted in an independent translation. It means that some prologues has been translated even four times. And so the process of change reflects that the prefaces weren't just non-functional supplements, but an integral part of the biblical vernacular text throughout the late Middle Ages.